New this morning on Daybreak, a nonprofit providing housing for the unsheltered community here in Springfield is investing in a new piece of technology that will change how it builds homes going forward. Color 10's Joshua Pineda live in Springfield this morning. Now Josh, after it's all said and done, Eden Village will be the first of its kind to implement something like this.
Jesse, after their groundbreaking of Eden Village 3, the nonprofit received a tremendous gift that will not only allow them to build homes more efficiently, but allow them to have a bigger impact in the community.
A donor came along and purchased two robotic 3D concrete printers, and that'll be the first village for the chronically homeless completely printed.
Nate Schluter told me in an exclusive interview, Eden Village will be able to save 40% of construction costs with this new piece of machinery. Right now, Eden Village is in the stage of pre-printing walls, engineering, and permitting, but Schluter says the nonprofit has never received a donation like this before.
We can use technology to respond rapidly to a catastrophe that's happening in our beautiful but very broken city. It's going to be life-changing for the individuals we're able to house, but life-changing for the donors and the operations and the volunteers to be able to see something come to fruition way quicker than traditional construction.
When construction is complete, Eden Village will be able to provide homes for 24 people.
As Eden Village prepares to build more homes for the unsheltered using cutting-edge technology, many communities across the nation are taking notice of the impact that the nonprofit is having right here in the Ozarks. We have Color 10's Joshua Pineda live at the site of the third Eden Village in Springfield. And Josh, the nonprofit, they hold conferences for other communities to come and learn about what they do. Talk to us about this.
Jesse, just last Friday, Eden Village had a grand opening in Wilmington, North Carolina. And Nate Schluter with Eden Village says it's amazing to see the nonprofit be able to reach other communities across the country.
Exciting time and something that we had never expected. We just wanted to house our friends here in Springfield and figured out an efficient way to do that. And other communities took notice and we're trying to help them out also.
Recently, Eden Village expanded in Kansas City, and here in a couple of weeks, they will have a groundbreaking ceremony in Tulsa, Oklahoma. As of right now, Schluter says there are 13 cities and 12 different states that have their own version of an Eden Village. He says in those conversations with different organizers and volunteers, it's not just about giving the homeless a home, but making them feel part of a community. Now, coming up at the 6 o'clock hour, I'll give you an update on the construction of the new Eden Village 3, including a new piece of technology used to build homes. Reporting in Springfield, I'm Joshua Pineda, Ozarks First.